We have three authors here from the group, which is, they're going to present on how to change your life. And it's Tiffany Kaharik, Amy Mead, and Rebecca Carswell. So please give them a welcome and let them tell you how to change your life.
Hi, everyone.
Hi.
3 years ago, myself and three other women formed a group. And we started this group to help each other reach goals. We met once a month for just 2 hours. That's it. Really, really incredible things started happening in all of our lives. So incredible that we felt compelled to share what we had created and also what we had discovered. This is how we decided to share it. We wrote a book about it. So today, three of the four of us are here telling you about this really amazing experience and about the group and how it's helped us in our lives and how it may be able to help you. So before we get started doing that, I want to introduce myself to you. My name is Rebecca Carswell. As a skydiver for over 12 years, I'm the announcer for the United States Parachute Demonstration Team, which is a lot of fun. I'm also the author of Hey, Are You Listening to Me? Listening Your Way to Professional and Personal Success, and I'm a public speaker. Amy.
I'm Amy Mead. I am a graphic designer, and I was in the advertising business for 15 years. I have a question for you, and I'd like you to think about the answer. What is something that you've always dreamed of doing? Big or small, doesn't matter. Just a goal of yours. Maybe you want a better relationship, more confidence, a new career, or maybe you want to grow your business, anything. Are you moving toward that goal? And if not, why? What do you think might be holding you back? What if you were surrounded by a group of people who wanted you to achieve your goal, your dream, just as much as you did? And these people believed in you completely. They knew that you could do it, even when you doubted it yourself sometimes. Imagine if they were there to listen to you, to listen to why you want to achieve your goal, and to help you move forward with your dream, to help you do it. Do you think it would be easier to achieve your dream? Do you think you would achieve your dream? Yes, absolutely you would. And probably more easily than you might think. I'd like to share something with you that is something that the group helped me with. When we first formed our group, I'd been trying to get pregnant for over a year. I was 38 years old, and every month that went by that I didn't get pregnant, I became more and more worried, more and more anxious, stressed, to the point that I was distraught. I was really upset and angry. I was very angry at myself because I felt like I had blown it. I felt like I waited too long and I'd blown my chance of having a child. So I shared all of this with my group at one of our meetings. And we talked about the obvious, which was, that I needed to relax and de-stress. And I needed to eliminate the negative thoughts that I was having that were going on in my head. And I needed to eliminate the anger that I had toward myself. I left that meeting with written and steps on how to let go of the negative thoughts that I was having and how to trust and relax. And I put them into practice. I put them to work. Only 3 months later, at one of our meetings, I was able to share that I was pregnant. After all that time of trying and distress, I was finally pregnant. Now I have an awesome 2-year-old little girl who I might not have if it wasn't for the group and for their support.
Believe me, it was really exciting to hear her share that. By the way, don't get the wrong idea.
It's not a pregnancy group.
I'm Tiffany Kaharik. I've been in the medical field for 14 years, and currently I'm a licensed massage therapist with Positive Change Health Center in Sebastian. I'm going to tell you all a little bit more about the group and how it all came to be. A few years ago, the four of us, Miri is not here today, she couldn't be with us, the four of us met through some mutual friends. We really didn't know each other that well at all at the time, but we got to talking about forming some kind of group, having meetings. And when we talked about why we wanted to have these meetings, we decided it would be nice to support each other in reaching our goals. But something else kept coming up that we wanted out of the experience. We wanted to add a little more magic, more inspiration to our daily lives. So we got together and created a process that we put in our book. It's a structure for the group meetings. It seemed like a good way to inspire us, motivate us, and help us reach our goals. But what we didn't realize was how powerful the experience was going to be for all of us. It surpassed anything we could have imagined. Not only were we accomplishing our goals pretty easily, so much more was happening in our lives. We were all becoming more at peace with ourselves and believing in ourselves more and developing this amazing bond, this really strong connection with each other. It's really difficult to put into words the magic that we created and that was happening within our group. But I'd like to try by sharing with you what the group did for me. Before I joined the group, I felt like I was in a rut. I had dreams and goals for my life, but I felt kind of stuck, like I never really moved forward with the things that I wanted to accomplish. I felt like something perhaps was missing from my life, like maybe I wasn't as happy as I thought I could be. So we formed our group, and honestly, after just a couple of meetings, things began to lift for me. I started feeling more positive and more confident, even happier. As I encouraged my group members and watched them take action toward their dreams, I couldn't help but be more motivated and inspired myself, and I started taking action towards my own dreams. Challenges no longer had the power they once seemed to have over me. The group gave me the confidence to rise above anything, any challenge, any obstacle. All of these positive effects were spilling over into every area of my life, my relationships at work, and come to find out, my group members were having the same kind of experience. It got to be so amazing that one night after one of our group meetings, we were just sitting around talking about how incredible our lives had changed. And we said, other people need to know about this. They'll want to have this experience we're having. Imagine what people's lives would be like, what the world would be like if more people had a group like ours. So how do we do this? How do we share this information? Well, that's the night we decided to write our book. Starting a group is so easy, And we've made absolutely sure of it. Every single step is outlined in our book. How to choose your group members, how to form a group, and how to hold group meetings. This book is a guide, but it's not only a guide. It's a resource for inspiration and a reminder that anything is possible. So who can you form a group with? Well, first of all, anyone can be a part of a group. You can be male or female, in your teens or in your 90s. Anyone. You can form a group with your family, with your friends, or even acquaintances, people you don't know very well. As I mentioned, the four of us didn't know each other that well when we formed our group, and we're best friends today. You can form a group in your business or organization. I have experienced this firsthand at work, or the place that I work at. We decided to change our monthly staff meetings into group meetings. So many amazing things happened. Our communication between all of the office staff improved immensely. Our teamwork increased. As we were helping each other achieve our individual goals, the office became unified. Everyone got more excited about pitching in and going the extra mile. Everyone felt more motivated and positive on a day-to-day basis, and our clients even mentioned that they noticed the change in the atmosphere in the office. And of course, that led to an increase in business, and we were all so much happier. It was a great experience. The group is one of the most uplifting and positive ways to spend 2 hours a month. That's all it takes. If you form a group, you will be amazed at how something this simple is so powerful.
Thanks, Tiffany. Thank you. I'm going to share with you one of the many things that the group has helped me personally with in my life. A couple of years before I met my group members, I had a very scary and interesting experience. It was a Saturday morning, and I was getting ready to do a skydive with a few friends of mine. Now, at that point, I had been skydiving for a few years. I had a little over 700 jumps, but something very different happened on this particular jump. When I jumped out of the plane stalled. Now, for those of you who don't know, when a plane stalls, it loses its lift. It actually starts to fall a little. So right at that exact moment that I jumped out of the plane stalled, started to fall, and hit me. Yeah, that's
my reaction. Oh my God.
So I was hit by an airplane.
Right?
I'm at 13,000 feet in the air. And unfortunately, it broke my back. Herniated discs in my neck. I had many, many months of recovery ahead of me. Doctors told me all kinds of things, that I would never be the same, I would never be able to do this or that again. I overcame all of that. I even started skydiving again. But there was this lingering after effect that stayed with me from that whole experience. That after effect was fear. So much fear. I was so afraid of getting hurt again. It wasn't just with skydiving though. This fear, it spilled over into other aspects of my life. And here's just one of many examples. When I was a passenger in a car, someone else was driving, I would be so afraid that we were going to hit the car in front of us. And I would think about it, and worry about it, and think, oh, my neck, my back, I wouldn't be able to handle it if that happened. And this fear went even further. Not only was I afraid that something was going to happen to me, I started becoming really afraid that something was going to happen to the people in my life that I really cared about, that I was closest to. I felt crazy sometimes with all of these scenarios playing out in my head, all of these shared all of this at one of our group meetings. Absolutely incredible. It was like a light bulb went off. So much became clear to me. One of the many realizations that I had was that the past doesn't equal the future. I can learn from the past, but if I let it control me and have power over me, then I'm missing out on life. Here and now, this, life. And I left that meeting with actual ideas and steps to take to continue letting go of this fear. And it was a matter of days, literally, only a matter of days before I felt such a sense of relief, like that fear and that worry was just lifted, gone. And it was all from taking that one step. And that step was sharing it with my group. Everything else fell into place after that, pretty easily, surprisingly easily. There's a quote that I love by, has anyone here heard of Lao Tzu? He wrote the Tao Te Ching. Couple of people, yeah. This is one of my favorite quotes. It's a great quote. It's by Lao Tzu. He was a Chinese philosopher. He lived close to 3,000 years ago. And he said, "A tree that reaches past your embrace grows from one small seed. A building over 50 stories high starts with a handful of dirt. A journey of 1,000 miles begins with one single step." Isn't that a great quote? A journey of 1,000 miles starts with one single step. That's exactly why we wrote the book. We believe so strongly in what we've created because of how it has helped us in our lives in really profound ways. And now one of our goals, a dream of ours, is that our book will help other people. Maybe you, in your life. So thank you so much for letting us share this with you. We hold it very dear to our heart. Thanks for coming on in this room and being a part of this with us. Yeah. And I think we have a couple of minutes. Do we have a few? We have a few minutes, right? Does anybody have any questions that they'd like to ask us or comments or anything to share?
Yeah. I missed the first part. Was it explained exactly what the group is?
We started a group a few years ago to help each other reach goals.
Okay.
And it turned into, it surpassed anything that was even in our wildest dreams.
Okay.
Not only were we reaching goals, but every aspect of our lives improved. We, at the end of every meeting, Tiffany talked about this, we would look at each other like, are you guys as happy as I am? Are things getting as incredible as they are for you? And it in 2 hours, once a month, it's amazing. Yeah.
That's wonderful. So the book is about starting your own group, or is it your personal story? What's in the book?
Both.
Okay.
Both. And even if I've had people say to me, I don't want to start a group, but I got so much out of your book. So, and Tiffany talked about it being a source of inspiration. It's incredibly motivating. And if you want to start a group, it's so simple. And some of our success stories are in there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you guys still call as a group now that you've reached your original goals?
Yeah. Every month. We wouldn't miss it for the world.
There's a starting, there's not an ending.
What's that?
There's a starting place, but not an ending for your career.
Right. No.
You just gotta keep it ongoing.
No ending.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you think 4 people is the right number, or how do you keep it just to 2 hours if you're all talking about your dreams?
Right. 4 to 6 people is perfect. If you only have 3, start it anyway. Do it. If you have 7 or 8, you can't. That's a little much, but 4 to 6 is great. And there's a whole structure outlined in the book. It's really simple, but it keeps you on track.
And everything is timed, segments.
So
kind of like a board meeting or something.
And each
much
meeting,
better than a board meeting.
Yeah, like, much more time. Like you, each person has their.
Well, each meeting, one person is designated to be honored that evening. So you rotate who's honored at each meeting. So, for example, I was honored at the last meeting. So for 1 hour, it's focusing on my goal.
So it's all about you that
it's
day.
It's all about that
oh,
one person.
That's
and then the next meeting, it goes. So you really get that focused attention and everyone's ideas and thoughts and questioning to help you draw the answers from yourself. And you leave with actual steps that you can take to start moving towards your goal.
Yeah, it's really powerful. Yeah, there's five segments total that just build upon each other. It's really, I get goosebumps even just to sharing it with you. It's wonderful. And they're all timed. There's a timer, roll of a timer that just keeps it on track, and bam, 2 hours, in and out. Yeah. Yes?
What did you have to go through to get your book published?
We had, you know, sometimes I think when things are meant to happen, the universe or whatever you want to call it just makes things easy for you. And a friend of a friend said, I know a publisher who I think would be really interested in this. And we said, really? Okay, let's meet and talk to him. And it was, and I know that that's not the norm. And we feel really grateful for how easy the whole experience was for us. Yeah.
I was curious with the fear, with the airplane falling on you, that was something you had absolutely no control over. So it's not like having fear where you made a mistake and then the fear of repeating it. That was a fear that you couldn't see coming.
Right. How did you get past that?
You know,
yeah.
How did you get past the fear of having no control over to say anything?
Right. And that was getting over the fear of not having control. And that was when I talked about being in the car when someone else was driving. I didn't have control and I'd be afraid we're going to hit that car. But I have, from being a part of the group, I have let go of a lot of like the need to control things, trusting. My life is so much easier and simpler. So it was really about just seeing, you know, I think everything happens for a reason. I need to trust the bigger picture, which I might never really know. But a lot of gifts came out of that experience, and the group has helped me find some of those gifts. Yeah.
Okay.
Good.
All right.
Well, one quick thing.
Oh.
When you go into the main entrance, we're at a round table right against the wall. So if you want to come over and just say, if you have other questions, or if you want to just say hello or chat to us, we'd love to see you. And thanks again for being here.
Okay. Yeah.